What's poppin'?
It's red. I posted a little bit of it being red in my last video there. A lot of people have been asking to do like a continuous video vlog, I don't know, of this thing. I don't know if I really want to do that. I don't think I work on it enough to do that, and I've got plenty of other stuff going on. But whatever, I really only get to work on it, you know, maybe a couple days a week, and that's tops. It's not really like full days by any means, but either way, I could get a little more work done. Before, I mean, the motor was in it, you guys saw that. I had fixed the motor mount locations so that it was level in the engine bay towards the end of that video, I think. Yeah, because I posted it when it was red. Either way, they were just through holes that the mounts were sitting in, so now they're threaded. I actually ended up drilling them out and welding, I don't know what you'd call it, bungs, I guess, into it so that the mounts actually thread into it. I got a couple cool things for it. My intentions with this car was to send the exhaust out of the passenger side fender, but not up top and stupid, down low and stupid. A little different. So I did start on that a little bit. I ended up polishing one side of the car some, the side with more paint. As you can see, there's a windshield on it, not in it. There was some rot I had to take care of around the windshield, which I know sounds kind of crazy for this thing, being as it's so trashed, but like I said, I wasn't going to fix any of it, but I did want to fix that. I know the car is going to leak water a lot, and I just really want to contain all the leaks to behind me. So that's fine. Or the passenger side. I don't care. I don't sit over there. So that's cool. Yeah, so I don't know. I guess we'll go into it a little bit. So as you can see, this is what I started for an exhaust. It's just 2 1/4. I had it laying around from some previous projects. It was actually from that MTDI I did for Haley in that tan car in one of the previous videos. So it's kind of silly because it's mounted, hard mounted to the chassis, which seems stupid, I'm sure. I actually plan on running a flex pipe in the engine bay so that it doesn't break all the welds on it and consistently rattle, although I'm sure it'll still figure out how to rattle. So all I did, I sent a 2.5 inch, actually it might have been a 2 5/8 inch hole saw through the side. It's enough where I'm going to weld a V-band on the other side, and I should be able to get the V-band back through. If not, I'll have to clearance it more, which is no big deal. There's 2 tabs on it for now. I think I'm going to put a 3rd one down there because right now it does have a little bit of play, though. I think it would be all right, but more the merrier. It does actually clear everything, you know, it doesn't hit anything, which is cool for now anyway. It's a bit higher because there's no motor in it, but it's above the point in the bay. That's a piece of red welding wire in a spot that I never welded, covered in factory seam sealer and factory red paint. Goes to show you, Volkswagen doesn't give a shit. Anyway, yeah, no, I plan on something just a little easy, a little different. I did actually notch the fender to fit that already, and it looks pretty good. The body line on the fender kind of sucked before, and actually it sits on the exhaust a little bit and kicks the body line back into normaler, whatever. Not a good car, not good body lines, what do you expect? But yeah, I thought that was kind of cool. I don't know. I'll show you with the fender on. Like I said, I polished up this side of the car a little bit. No, not so bad. So that should be kind of cool. You know, I'm sure this side will end up constantly disgusting, but so am I. What's the difference?
Another thing, You know, as you saw before, there was a 1.6 in there. It's a naturally aspirated 1.6, but I threw some TD stuff on it when it was in my buddy Cole's little shitbox rabbit. He is afraid of diesels or something. I don't know, pussy. So he gave me that motor, like I mentioned in the last video, and we ran it before with the stock TD stuff on it. But I've got some cool stuff now, thanks to this kid Ben I'm friends with. He's from Canada originally, moved to Gainesville, just in the area here. You know, pretty cool stuff. But you can see I got the motor pulled with my sweet wrecker. Huh? The old swamp donkey. She's still doing to it. Yeah, check this stuff out. You ready? I think it's cool. Ooh. How many of y'all know what that is? That's Bob's Automotive Engineering Turbo Kit for a 1.5, actually, Volkswagen diesel. It's supposed to be 30 extra horsepower and 65 miles to the gallon, according to a couple articles and brochures. I think it looks cool. And hopefully it continues to work. That's all I care about. I don't care if it's faster or more economical. I hope it's makes the right noises and looks cool. As you can see, it's a pretty neat little setup. Like I said, Bob's Automotive Engineering. They were out of California. I guess the guy's actually like a wicked dickhead. I don't know if it's still him, but the company's pretty miserable to deal with. They made a bunch of compound stuff for 12-valve and 24-valve Cummins, but apparently when it would break, they'd kind of tell you to fuck off, which is kind of shitty, but I always thought this stuff was super cool. It's a Ray J Turbo, Rajay, I don't know, something, but you can't really find parts for them much. I know that company, not BAE, but Rajay or whatever it is, they made a lot of turbos for, you know, implements, farm tools, you know, tractors, whatever. I don't know. But seems like everything I find is for bigger equipment type stuff. Obviously, it's a non-intercooled setup. They came out with this in 1978. Volkswagen didn't create any turbo stuff for the diesels until, I believe, 82 or 3. I know we didn't get a Jetta until 83 with a TD. And I don't think we got Rabbits until what very few we got, I think, was 83. So, I don't know. Either way. But, see, it's actually date stamped. What is that? April 29th of 1980, which is pretty cool. So it's the same year as ye old shitbox, which is pretty neat. I'm missing the little 90 degree pipe, but I don't think that's a big deal. I assume the kid I got this from, Ben, probably cleaned it all up. He's, you know, he polishes wheels and stuff like that. So I assume he probably cleaned it up because I can't imagine that this thing was actually that clean sitting there. I had the turbo disassembled a little earlier. Ben mentioned that the oil seals in it were kind of shit. He never ran it, but he said he disassembled it, made noise before, you know, just scrapey noises or whatever. And I went through it and it was actually assembled wrong. I don't know if Ben had done that or somebody prior. I'm going to assume somebody prior. He said he bought it at like a hot rod swap meet sitting under somebody's bench and they were like, not really sure what it was, I'm sure, but pretty cool little piece. I don't know that it's ever going to be near as efficient really as the stock K24 that's on the little 1.6 that could. But I guess we'll see, won't we? I really just think it'll look cool, but I'm going to face a little bit of issues with it. So if you can imagine, you know, this is the backside of the motor. So intake is coming out, inlet is coming out on the driver's side now, whereas if you're familiar with 1.6 TDs, it is the other way. The inlet is coming in off the passenger side. And that means now my exhaust is going to be here, which is cool, but I think it's going to have to come up and I don't know how much room I have. So I'm going to do a little time lapse. I'm going to try to send this turbo off to this guy, Tim, up in Virginia. Tim's Turbos. He does some really cool stuff. You should check him out on Instagram. It is literally just Tim's Turbos. He does some pretty crazy shit. He shows how to balance them. You know, he laser balances everything. If he can't find parts for stuff, he makes parts for stuff. So that's pretty cool. So I'm going to see if I can make a little time lapse of me trying to put it on the motor and I guess using the truck to put the motor back in ye olde shitbox. Now I can actually bolt it into. The motor's not going to stay in. I actually have to pull the motor once again. I want to do my axle notches with the motor out, just make it a little bit easier. And by that, I mean, I'm going to try to convince my friend Cole to make the axle notches so I don't have to do it, because he keeps stealing my work with axle notches, so he might as well do my own too, right? He did mine on the little black car. You should see him. He did such a great job. They're half welded. They're so good. Really good. But, you know, that car deserves it. So, yeah, we'll see how it goes. I got the engine already hooked up onto this thing backwards, so that's stupid. But, yeah, we'll see. As you can see here, you know, it mounts a little differently. Oil lines are all different. Everything is massively different, and it's really stupid. I shouldn't try to run it. You know, I'm sure it'll be more problematic than the stock proven known working stuff that we were using. But hey, it's right on par, huh? So let's see if I can set this up and make some dumb video. So this right here is exactly what my fear was. That is exhaust. I'm not so sure that's gonna work. This was something that was in my mind. It looks like axle clearance could be okay, though I fear axle clearance might actually be an issue with this tower. I think it would be more towards tower instead of the turbo. But as you can see, you know, Mark III mount, something set up for a Mark I that didn't really envision Mark III mounts. So that is a bummer. I was toying around with it earlier, and I had the turbo apart, like I said, and I was clocking it different ways. I didn't realize at first that it was opposite of what a stock 1.6 TD would have been. So I was toying around with it, and I actually did figure out a way to clock it differently and set it up so that the inlet was on that side, exhaust on that side. So that might end up having to be what I do, I guess. Bummer. I'm going to put the intake on just to look at it real quick. And, well, I guess we can just bang that out real quick, can't we? Nope. Nope, I guess I can't, apparently. So, whatever. You get the point. I am really kind of into this setup, you know, so I really would like to run it. If I can, I can't, you know, whatever. If I have to put it off till down the road or something, I will. That is a huge bummer. But, we'll see. We'll see. So I guess we're gonna try to turn it around. It's got a triangular bolt hole pattern, similar to that. Obviously not that, but similar to that. So we have three different ways we can turn it, and one way is just obviously not gonna work. You know, because it would just have the intake inlet, keep going on an intake inlet, just shoved right into the back of the block, which obviously is not feasible. So we will see what we can do. Like I said, you do have to tear the turbo down a little bit. Nothing crazy, just pull the cold side off, loosen the V-band that holds the hot side to the cartridge, and then you can clock it all around. So it's fairly easy, which is nice. Pretty straightforward. I will take the feed. There's some sort of adapter on this turbo feed. I don't know if how they had it set up. They had a hard line and it wouldn't reach or something. Kind of weird. I guess theoretically it could be a one of them things in there. You know, not a reducer, but a reducer. What do they call that? A restrictor. A restrictor. Yeah, so, cold side, there's just six flush set Allens. They're 4 millimeters on these. I did not tighten them very much because I wasn't sure if this would be an issue or not. I guess I have to take the drain off. The drain is in the way. Like everything else, zippy day. Check out these honking big boys. It's quite a bulk for a drain. Pretty cool drain, though. It says BAE right on it. Good old Bay. Bob. Thanks, Bob. Fucking should have realized this was going on a wrong car with Mark III mounts. Idiot. No wonder why you're a dickhead. Bob, if you see this, sorry. And if you're dead, please don't haunt me. Or at least do cool shit if you do haunt me. That'd be cool. Like fucking use your ghost arms to pick up a cat in the house and just like make a flying cat. So everybody just thinks I'm fucking crazy. That'd be cool. Yeah. Easy, breezy, beautiful. CoverGirl. Whoop. Too much. Too much. Okay. So. That's how it was, I guess. This is how we're gonna try it. My worries with this is still exhaust. And a Volkswagen, when they did the TD stuff for the Rabbit and Jetta, and the, basically the A1 platform followed all the way through till even some Mark IIIs. Canada got the Golf CL, which was like a, Canada got something with a 1.9 AAZ, which is just a IDI 1.9 turbo diesel. Everything on their motors was designed probably better than this, but the turbo, instead of it being crooked like it is, was straight. So it was real easy to just go straight down with the exhaust. Intake lined up pretty good. Both intake and inlet lined up pretty good. The filter housing got in the way, so they put them on the firewall. Now I sound like Bobby. Filter housing's on the firewall and not on the tower. That's why his shit's nicer than mine, though. Anyway, yeah. So that leaves us kinda off on where we gotta be. So that's the inlet in a fairly right area. Inlet, the turbo feed, I mean, sorry. Now obviously I'm gonna have to do something creative going from this to this. I already don't have the factory pipe, so what's the difference, right? If I have to make something, it's not a big deal. Just a little whoop whoop. Could probably even kick it back further and go like this. I don't know, might have to, but this will at least give me the right idea. Maybe. So we'll zip those Allens in, tighten up that V-band, and we'll see. Guess I'm only gonna put half the Allens in, as this may not work in the first place. A lot of people have been messaging me, telling me to make more videos like this. I don't really know, should I? It makes me feel awkward. I am literally in the middle of the woods with nobody but my dog and several cats home. Hopefully. And they're all sitting in the living room right now, watching me going, who the hell is this moron talking to? That's weird. I don't know. If people like them, I'll do them, I guess. I don't know. I don't do the best work. I just do work that works. So it's not like I'm teaching you guys. I mean, I gotta teach you how to be a hack, I'm sure. I'm sure that's exactly what these videos are going to be. Point in case.
So, round two. Let's see how it goes this time. Don't hold your breath. We'll see. know, maybe I could bend up a better tower, you know, engine tower. Yeah, see, this won't even work at all. I can't even test fit it, so that means even if I did make up a tower on this situation, the turbo would be right on top of my mount. Shit, man. I really, really, really want to run this thing.
Obviously, that's upside down,
which won't work. Just some goofing off. Just some goofing around. Hey, now we're cooking. Nah, I'm just kidding. This manifold does not clear the exhaust manifold. I don't know what to do on this one. Man, that's a super bummer. Super bummer. I'm sure I could trim up the intake and make it work. But, like, I don't know that I want to. I'm all about modifying chassis and cars and stuff that doesn't usually break. Everything breaks, but stuff that usually has a longer wear duration. So I don't really care to modify parts. I don't want to modify stuff because when you break down, if you don't have all the tools to modify stuff, again, you're screwed because you built your shit and you can't use it now, or replace it rather. It always happens at car shows, for me, meets, whatever. You modify something and then, oh, look at that. It broke and now you need said part and the tools to remodify it, and usually you're on a time crunch. Man, this is getting redonkulous. Man, that's really a bummer. It's real convenient how easy that stock turbo stuff fits. I don't know if you've noticed, I'm not very into convenience. This is the awkward silence of, you done fucked up. But this is why you test fit stuff. Together out, together out, together out, together out, all apart, together apart, together apart. Never stops. But this is why you test fit stuff. Man! What am I gonna do? This sucks. I really, 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 really wanted it. I wanted one of these kits for so long. But maybe I will have to save it for another car. Man. Why the hell do they have to design that thing backwards? That's dumb. It was like, if this was over here, then I could... Well, obviously this is right here. So, I guess I won't be test fitting that. Now, will I? I don't know. What would you guys do? Would you try to butcher that? Make one that works? I don't want to, but maybe, because, like I said, there might be axle clearance down the chute issues with the stock TD stuff. The drain that I made hits the mount. It actually has to go up behind it, which is cool about the stock mount. You know, the drain can go out and right behind it all, which is cool, and it keeps it away from the axle. I've had one rub through the axle. I mean, one have it. Whatever. Huh. Well, that super sucks. I guess for tonight, I might call it quits, go brainstorm a little bit. You win some, you lose some. That's part of shitboxing. I guess.